Gordon. You're welcome to Cusey Park. We have first of the Milltown crew here, of course. Never leaves it, nearly never leaves Cusey Park.
Yes.
Michael Dalton, that right, Michael?
That's right, Holly, yeah.
You're looking forward to a big one today, Mike.
We are indeed, Holly, yeah, looking forward to a big one.
You're due an old cup out around Milltown now. It's a long time since we've seen one floating around there.
Yeah, 96 now, we've had turtles passing. We've been in a few already up to that, and this one now is a lot of young players involved. It'd be grand for them to pull it off today. Having said that, Morning Jar, Shamrocks, I saw them playing, and they're also a young team. And they have, but Milltown, I think, now should do it today, Ollie. That's my honest opinion, and it'll be delighted for them to see them.
Conditions are not going to be the best by the looks of things. The rain begins to come now at the wrong time, so is that going to affect the game?
I don't think so, Ollie. No, I don't think so. I don't think so. No, I think our lads will be well acclimatised to that. Martin Lynn and stuff are doing a great job with them this year now, as they say that. And, nice, as I said earlier, to see them pulling off, especially for Johnny Dillon and Mick and Tommy and some of the senior players as well. And it's a great lift for the young lads, you know yourself, and for the club as a whole.
Mick, we leave it at that. We look forward to a sporting game of football.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Michael.
Thanks, Robert.
Looking man here, but I'm sure deep down he's not a bit worried. Aidan Daly, Aidan.
Oh, yeah, Ollie.
Willie Garshamert. How are things in the camp?
Good. Fairly nervous, that's the only thing.
Well, looking at a lot of the lads out there, they shouldn't be nervous. They've already picked up a minor championship already this year, so I'm sure there's a bit of a high in the camp at the moment, Aidan.
There is, but that can be a bad thing in a way. The lads are playing intermediate, or they're playing adult football now, and it's a big difference. They're going into an adult final, which requires a bit more dedication or a bit more commitment and a bit more fire to take an adult championship.
Well, looking at them in the minor final, they performed very well, but as you say, adult competition is a big step.
Of course.
I suppose in a way it's a bit unfair, but I suppose that's the way things are going. Yeah. Looking at the Milltown line-out, there's quite a number of young lads, so it'll balance out fairly well at the end of the day, maybe, Eden.
Definitely, yeah, and Milltown are a junior club, and it's a big thing for Milltown. It's their main team, and of course they'll be very hungry for this title.
Well, Aidan, what can we say at this stage? We wish you the best of luck, and young or old, I'm sure you're hoping to bring home a title this evening.
Oh, it'll be great, yeah.
Aidan Daly, thank you very much.
Lovely. Thanks, Alan.
Now, as things begin to warm up before our final here, we'll have a quick word with the man that's caused all the shots around Milltown the last number of months, Martin Finn.
Glyn.
Martin. How are things? We've got some lads going in there, looking well.
Looking well and very relaxed. We had a cup of tea in Danny Burns and it was a great idea to break the tension, and the guys are very relaxed and very focused. That's the main thing.
Well, they're all looking forward to it. It's a few years now. We talked to Mick Dalton nearly since they brought back a cup to Milltown. I'm sure you'll be doing your utmost to bring one back this evening.
Absolutely. 7 years, and there's eight of the panel from 1996 that were making jerseys and bunting and all in the national school that day, so there's seven of them playing here this evening, so that's the way we went with youth.
Mullingar Shamrocks, a very youthful team.
Absolutely, Mullingar will be up for this big time. Ned Moore will have them absolutely hopping. We beat them, we're lucky, very lucky to beat them in the championship by a point. That'll have no bearing on the game whatsoever today, but they'll be flying, we know that.
Martin, we won't delay you any longer. What can we say? The best of luck.
Thanks,
Martin
Glynn.
Well done, Martin. The man that calls all the shots, chairman, Johnny Geraghty. Johnny, you're smiling. Uh-huh. Will we be smiling in an hour's time, Johnny?
I would hope so, yeah, I think so we will.
How are things at the camp?
The team never was better in the camp. We have a very young team taking the field today, which is unusual for Milltown.
Well, that's a sign of good things in the future, Johnny.
Yeah, it mightn't, maybe, you know, it mightn't be our day, but having said that, we'll enjoy it, and it'll be a great experience for the young lads.
Well, you're playing again at a very youthful side in Mullingar Shamrocks. Most of them on the minor team have won the championship this year, so it'll be a good pair. Normally, junior is taken as a rugged, bugged team, but two very youthful teams
today.
Two
very youthful teams, and I expect to see a good open game of football today. Having said that, probably the rain will probably have an effect on it, you know, but it's as good for one as the other.
You're looking forward to it, Johnny?
We're looking forward to it. We're looking forward to the cup in Condor this evening.
What can we say, Annie? Wish you the best of luck.
Thanks very much.
And maybe we might be having another chat later on this evening.
Please God.
Johnny Geraghty, thank you very much.
Thanks very much, all.
Agusanish, Talshenan doing Forge Kur with Misham Roga, Orson Bunningar. And you might show your appreciation for the match officials. I'll just get them all here.
Ladies and gentlemen, here, the Gillarin sponsored Westmeath Junior Football Final for 2003. Ball up in the air, Gary Moore goes for it. Caught by Michael Spike Fagan. Spike out onto the left hand side of the pitch over near the terrace side. John Ganley has it. John is knocked to the ground, gets up again. Nice ball out. Alan Carnally with the ball now. Getting ahead to get through, but he's gotten through. He's going straight in on goal. Connolly onto the right foot. Kicks. And it's... it's gone wide. Looked like it was over the bar, but it's gone wide. First attack of the game. Alan Connolly from Mullingar Shamrocks. At wing half forward. There's no change, ladies and gentlemen, to the teams as they're lined out in the programme. And goals for Milltown, Damien Byrne. Full back line. Tom Dillon, Patrick Riley and Patrick Gavigan. Half-back line, Aidan Scally, Conor Riley and Michael Ward. Centre the field, Damien Gunning and Paul Mulvaney. Number 10, Fergal Riley. Centre half-forward, Willie Keegan and Francis McLaughlin. Damien Gunning makes a fabulous catch at the centre of the field. It's coming out to it is Simon Cashman. Cashman off the minor team, the Shamrocks minor team. Number 11 has it now for Mullingar Shamrocks. That's John Ganley going through. Ganley knocks it outside. Carnally with the ball again. Carnally is showing himself very well early on, but he's a great block down. Super block down. And he's fouled. Carnally is fouled. Quick free in. Colm O'Donovan with the ball. O'Donovan onto the left foot. Strikes. It's blocked again. Going through. Keane O'Leary. And O'Leary knocks over the first score of the 2003 Gillarin sponsored Westmeath Junior Football Final. Keane O'Leary with the first score. He was centre half forward on the Mullingar Shamrocks minor team here that played a fortnight ago that won the minor championship final. Shamrocks have made a bit of a brighter start here today. But it's early days yet. I was on to the teams. Fergal Riley, Willie Keegan and Francis McLaughlin at the half forward line for Milltown. Corner forward Danny Skelly. Full forward Stephen Summers. And at top of the right it's Michael Dillon. Great ball to the centre of field. O'Leary gets it again. O'Leary, bad ball, but it's gathered up. Gathered up by John Colm O'Donovan. Peter Collins has the ball now. Peter won a minor championship medal. Gary Moore. Gary, son of Ned, the manager. Gary, a great tackle. It's knocked off his hands. Peter Collins has it. On to the left foot. Kicks. Looks like it's heading. No, it's holding up in the wind. And a great catch. A great catch at cornerback. Coming out with the ball now. Fergal Riley. Fergal has it. Well blocked down. Well blocked down there from Willie Keegan. And it's a sideline ball. Willie Keegan to take. Willie on the terrace side of the pitch. Plays it short. Damien Gunning. Drops the ball. Lucky to get it back, Damien Gunning. He had his hand on the ball and he dropped it. Willie Keegan again. Keegan, crossfield ball. Nice ball. Michael Dillon, Mickey Dillon with the ball. Oh, well intercepted, Mihal Curley. Curley down along the wing to Collins. Collins grabs. It's hard to hold the ball today, it's very slippy. Keane O'Leary going through again. O'Leary, this is his third final this year. O'Leary strikes with the left. Left and wide. Just wide. Shamrock's putting on considerable pressure here now in the first 5-10 minutes of the game. Mullingar Shamrock's line out as follows. Darragh Ryan in goal, Zone O'Mara, David Miller and Simon Cashman. Gary Moore, Micheál Curley at centre halfback, and Paddy O'Donnell, the pop is at number 7. Spike Fagan at centre of the field along with Keane O'Leary. Fiacre Spellman, John Ganley and Alan Cornelli is the half forward line, and the full forward line, Darren Moore, Colm O'Donovan, and top of the right is Peter Collins. Gathered in for Milltown now. Number 10 is Fergal Riley. Riley up along the sideline. Falls out of the grasp. Nicely picked up by Shamrocks. Micheál Curley again. Curley seems to be all over the pitch again as he was in the minor final. Centre half forward. John Ganley. Ganley takes on his man. He's gone past him. He's striding through. He's on to the 14. Cuts across goal. Ganley, what's he going to do here? Oh, poorly struck ball by John Ganley. He made such a great run and such a poor finish at the end of it. But it looks like he has the beating so far of the centre half back for Milltown. That's Conor Riley. Conor's got to get into the game if he's going to hold John Ganley. Ganley is a speedy merchant. Kick out now to Bacon. Damien Byrne for Milltown. Great kick out towards the centre of the field. Oh, finally caught. Damien Gunning. A long time toiling in the Milltown colours. Into Johnny Dillon. Tommy Dillon. Tommy. He's trying to get past Simon Cashman. Cashman gets it. And Podge Green has called a foul. A foul. Foul on Danny Scally. Centre half forward, Willie Keegan has it. Knocks it wide. Who's going to get there? Holding it up for Milltown now. Back out, Willie Keegan again. Willie with the flowing locks. Picks the ball up. He's fouled. Take it from behind. Quick ball in. Into Stephen Summers. They're trying to isolate Summers as the St. Patrick's team did in the minor final. He's a fine footballer. Oh, there's a great ball out to Damien Gunning. Out in his own at the centre of the field. Tom Dillon trying to go through. He's stopped, he's blocked, and it's a free. Stopped by Simon Cashman and Paddy O'Donnell, and it's a free into Milltown. Seeking to record their first score of the game. Stephen Summers to take. This is a fine footballer from the Milltown club. He had a great game on the day of the minor final. And he struck it, and it's over the bar. Stephen Summers with the first score for Milltown. A point after roughly 6 minutes of play. A free from the 14-yard line. And it's level scores here after roughly 6 minutes, a point apiece. Good flowing game so far. It's difficult conditions. The ground is greasy. Ball is wet. It's raining outside. Referee Podge Green, the Tubberclare club, keeping an eye around the centre of the field. So far he hasn't had much to do, but he's keeping a good eye on it now at the moment. Dara Ryan, another member of Mullingar Shamrock's minor team for this year. Minor championship winner, ball out towards the centre of the field. It's grabbed. Number 10, Willie Keegan into Damien Gunning again. It's a great ball in. And Simon Cashman gets a hand to it. Well held by Micheál Curley. Curley coming out with the ball now, striding down the field. He's kicked it, but it slid off his boot and gone out over on the terrace side of the field. Darren Moore, Mullingar Shamrock's corner forward, just couldn't make it to it. Sideline to be taken. Tom Dillon plays it short. Nice ball in. Willie Keegan again. Well held up, but Willie Keegan has it again, and it's a free in. Willie, a foul after the ball. Willie to take it. Drives it in towards goal. Who's up for it? Spike Fagan is up for it. But coming out is David Miller. David, captain of Shamrock's minor team last year. Gary Moore down along the stand side of the pitch. A great ball in. Fiacre Spellman, the class act in the minor final. Into John Ganley. Ganley has the ball. And a free in. I didn't quite see what that is. It must have been fouling off the ball. Because Podge Green has brought it right into the 14-yard line, dead straight in front of the goals. There must have been some off-the-ball tactics there, because Podge Green is fairly adamant as he's bringing the ball right into the 14-yard line. Free to be taken by Darren Moore. Darren, another member of the Shamrocks minor squad this year. Championship winner already, kicks it, and it's over the bar. It's over the bar. Shamrocks take the lead, 2-1. Good movement by Mullingar Shamrocks there, and Pod Green spotted something off the ball. He certainly has his eye on the game. He's watching everything that's going on. It's been quite a good start. Good flowing football here, and very testing conditions, it has to be said. It's not very easy to hold the ball or even to run with the ball today. It's going to be very difficult. Big, strong, swirling breeze. Spellman gets it, but drops it. But he has it again. Faker Spellman out to number 5. Gary Moore from Mullingar Shamrocks. Driving through. Gary stands, looks up. Well blocked down. Well blocked down by the Milltown number 7, Patrick O'Donnell. Milltown number 7, Michael Ward. Kicked in, Spellman. Into Dean O'Leary, drops it out of his hand. Well taken by Paul Mulvaney. Mulvaney out towards the wing. Paddy O'Donnell goes for it. Paddy O'Donnell gets. Knocks it in. A bit high. But Alan Connolly has it. Connolly speeding through again. Connolly seems to have the run of this. 14, Callum O'Donovan kicks it and it's over the bar. A lovely score from Callum O'Donovan. Well worked in there. Paddy O'Donnell made a great job getting the ball. Knocked it into Connolly. Connolly skinned his man into Callum O'Donovan. And it's 3-1 here. After roughly 7 minutes of the game. Good lively start here. It's cracking football for the conditions, but in a big, strong, sterling breeze. Looks like it's blown from the bum scores end of the pitch up in the centre of the field. Knocked down by Spike Fagan, out of the grasp of Damien Gunning. Faker Spellman has it in his hand. Spellman, long ball, great ball into Darren Moore. Darren doesn't catch it the first time, but knocks it back down to himself. Hops it twice. Hops it twice and gives it away to free. Quickly out. Quickly out. Milton number 12. Oh, that was a late tackle by Gary Moore. Ball knocked in. Willie Keegan has it. No, knocked out of his hand brilliantly by Michael Tully. Spike Fagan with the ball. Long cross-field pass. Not going to make it. There is Darren Moore. And coming out with the ball is number 2, Tom Dillon, the captain of the Milltown side. In towards the centre of the field. Damien Gunning now. Gunning drives it high. In towards the centre goal. See so much men coming out for it. And a push in the back by David Miller gives the free in to Milltown. A foul on Stephen Summers, which he'll take himself. He's just on the 21-yard line here, kicking into the Dunstores end of the pitch. Stephen Summers kicks with the right foot. It's not over the bar, but Willie Keegan is grabbed and well blocked down by Summers. Bit of a muddle down there, but looks to be coming out with a Michael Curley again. Out toward the centre of the field, but he doesn't find his man and goes straight to Damien Gunning. Gunning with the right. It's a cross field. Coming out with it is Simon Cashman. Cashman is fouled. Cashman is fouled coming out with the ball. Michael Dillon looks like he fouled Simon Cashman. That time Cashman just made it to the ball before Mikey. And he takes the free. Cashman out towards the centre of the field. Oh, one pass through to Spellman. And there's no Mulligan Summer clear running onto it. But running onto it is the Milltown fullback. That's Patrick Riley. Patrick knocks it through. Into centre half back. Connor Riley. Connor kicks it across field. It's high ball, but Paddy O'Donnell is under it. No, he's not. Number 2 for Mullingar Shamrocks. That's Owen O'Mara gets a foot to it. Coming out of it now. Mullingar Shamrocks fullback. David Miller. Miller down along the centre of the field. Who's going to get to it first? No. Oh, it's a gun. It's slipped. It's fallen all over the place. And Colin O'Donovan has fouled. He's fouled Damien Gunning in the process of picking up the ball. He was fouled there. Taking the free. Tom Dillon. Milton's captain. Long serving him. Milton's head. Into Mickey Dillon. Mickey has the ball. Drives it towards the corner. A lovely ball. Coming through. Willie Keegan. That's it short. It's a great move so far. But I'm afraid it's wide. It's wide just to the left-hand side of the post. But a great flowing move by Milton there. Some lovely football played there by Milton. It looks like Danny Scully got the final kick to the ball. And it was a great move. Possibly deserved the score, but it's gone to left and wide. And it's 3 points for Mullingar Shamrocks. And 1 point to Milton. Ball high over everybody's head. Going first. Willie Keegan, but Spellman is there. What a pick up off the ground. He has all the skill. In towards Darren Moore. Darren has it. Darren knocks it. Didn't get enough purchase on it, but he knocks it into Peter Collins. Darren kicks it himself this time. Ah, what a score. The stand side of the pitch on his right foot. Darren Moore has knocked it clean over the bar. Four points to one after roughly 11-12 minutes. 13 minutes now, Clint Henry, 13 minutes gone here in the Killeen-sponsored Westmead Junior Football Final 2003. Damien Byrne with the kick-out from Milltown. Out, fine kick-out towards the centre of the field. Up for it goes Damien Byrne, makes a great catch. He's fouled, Diamond fouls him as he's in the attempt to kick on the ball. And it'll be a free for Damien Byrne. Milltown playing against the wind in the first half, it looks like. Wind looks like it's going down from the bench towards the centre of the field. Damien Byrne now with the ball. Out towards the right. It looks like, yes, Owen O'Mara. O'Mara drops it. It goes into Danny Scully, picked up. Number 10 from Milton, Fergal Riley, still with the ball. Out to Scully again. Scully strikes, right foot. It's in towards the goal. Oh, what is it? Lucky there. Coming in. Couldn't see who's coming in there. Darryl Ryan looked as if he was trying to usher it out wide, but coming in and was Stephen Summers, the Milton full forward. And Mullingar Summers has got to be careful with Summers. He's fairly lethal. He had an excellent game in the minor final here less than 2 weeks ago. And again, he's going to cause problems again today. Paddy O'Donnell wing, that's perfect. O'Donnell doesn't get this one. Doesn't get this one. Francis McLaughlin with the ball. Passing on the ground. Willie Peter coming through. Willie still has the ball. What is taken off him by Spike Fagan. 43 years of age and he's still going in the fighting. Being in Mullingar Summit. Peter Collins doesn't make it to the ball. Paul Mulvaney with it. And Mulvaney is fouled. Mulvaney kicked free. Keegan again. Keegan seems to have the freedom of the park at the moment. But a great interception by Owen O'Mara. Paddy O'Donnell gets it. Out the wing. Coming towards Spellman again. Spellman. Surely he was fouled. His arm was held there. But referee Pat Green doesn't give it. 15. Nicky Dillon. And he's given the free this time. I thought Spellman was fouled there. But Pat Green said no. And he's the referee. It doesn't matter what I say. It doesn't matter what anybody else says. It's up to the man in black today. Willie Keegan. Looks like an injury over on the far side. I can't just see who it is at the moment. It looks like the Milltown wing half forward. Could it be Francis McLaughlin? Looks like him, but he's okay. He's recovered. Willie Keegan now. Halfway between the 40-yard line and the 21. In towards goal. Up to the goal. There's a tackle towards goal. For it comes back out there. Danny Scully. Danny, another young player on this Milltown side. Nice football. Out to Willie Keegan again. Willie Keegan seems to have a rolling goal here today. They're coming out with it. Yes. Mullingar Summers looked like they're coming out with the ball. Darryl Moore there made a great tackle. Michael Foley out towards Spellman. Second Spellman there today. He's had a wonderful championship so far. And he's also had a brilliant game in the minor final. Simon Cashman. Cashman into Collins. Collins on his own. Into John Ganley, centre half. It's actually Colin O'Donovan. Colin O'Donovan, Darren Moore going for the ball. It goes over the head. No, it doesn't. Oh, wonderful catch by number two. Tom Dillon, and he's fouled after the ball. Peter Collins fouled him after the ball. And Peter Collins could be the first man into the referee's book today. No, he's just kicking. No, he had a card just yet, but it was a late tackle. There's not a hurt. Oh, very bad kick by Damien Byrne. And it comes to Peter Collins. Keen O'Leary, he eventually got it. That's out to Colin O'Donovan. Out to Alan Carnelli. Carnelli, left footed. No power, but O'Leary, he's got it in front of the goals. Can he score? Oh! It's come straight across the goal, but still not that out. What a chance for Keen O'Leary. But it's just down a baby, and Milton have cleared it. Willie Keegan, a great catch. That's it all. Simon Cashman knocks it down. Back to Keegan though. He only knocked it down to Keegan. And coming out with the ball. Oh, it's a terrible pass. Danny Scully. Paddy O'Donnell is on him. Paddy trying to hold him up. He does hold him up. Willie Keegan, but he gets his ball pass out. Patrick Gavigan. Gavigan along the ground, but just to find his man coming out on O'Mara. Out to Connelly. Connelly at the centre of the field. Connelly, a high ball, but it's going nowhere. Number 9, Paul Mulvaney coming out with the ball. Oh, he's made a very bad pass. coming into it now though, Callum O'Donovan. Oh, Cornelly drops it just at the 5-3 time. Can he make it back to it? No, he doesn't. Number 3, fullback, Patrick Riley coming out. Willie Keegan again. Keegan up along this stand side of the pitch. That's the throw. Mulvaney again. Mulvaney high over the heads of the Mullingar Shamrocks player. Danny Scully. Scully puts it into Summers. And David Miller looks like he's coming out with the ball, but it's only going to come to Damien Gunning. Gunning putting through. Kicks it with the right. The team goes, goals. Stephen Summers got a hand in it, but he doesn't make enough contact. Darryl Ryan, a great save. Darryl Ryan, after. And coming out to it now, Gary Moore. Oh, great interception. Great interception by Paddy Riley. In Willie Keegan, Mickey Dillon, number 15. And he's fouled. Shamrocks really should have cleared that ball at every opportunity. Gary Moore coming out with it and it's knocked out of his hand. A brilliant interception there by Patrick Riley. Set up the attack here for Newtown. And Stephen Summers will come out to take this free just outside the 21-yard line. Comes towards the end of the pitch. Summers looking to double Milltown's tally. Only 1 point so far, but it's been a cracking good first half. And great football by both sides under very, very testing conditions, it has to be said. Kicks left and it's right. It's the second three that Milltown have missed here for a fairly scoreable run. But you've got to remember, they're playing into a fairly stiff breeze here. The ground is left. It's very hard to play here today. Very hard, heavy wind. Strong wind. Looks like it's blowing from the gun stores under the pitch. Darryl Ryan with the kickoff now from Mullingar. Darryl Ryan out towards the centre of the field. Keane O'Leary grab. Van gets. O'Leary starting down along the stand side of the pitch. He's still going. Paul Mulvaney trying to get to him. A cross field ball into Darren Moore. Darren can't hold it. Can't hold it. And Milltown's captain comes out. Tommy Dillon and wins a free. Quick ball in, Damien Gunning, centre the field, high ball, in towards Summers again, it's gone over the back, Simon Cashman, no, he's gone with it, 3-in, 3-in foul on Danny Stallion, a promising move from Newtown there, and I think Simon Cashman, looking he made that interception, and possibly even the foul with him, Newtown looked like Newtown was clean through there, Danny Stallion was almost clean through one goal if he'd have collected that ball. Cashman made the interception, fouled, and I don't think if there's such a thing, it was a good foul to make. Hello. Summers now again on the 21. Really should be putting these over if Milton are going to stand any chance in this game. Very low scoring so far, but under the conditions, that's perfectly acceptable. Summers strikes with the right foot, and this time it is over the bar. 4 points to 2. Stephen Summers with both Milltown scores so far. Hard to get scores to do. It's going to be fairly vital who gets them. Both teams at a great pace. This game has been played at a wonderful pace today. Both giving very wholehearted commitment. Darryl Ryan. Fights the ball. Out towards Gary Moore, great catch by Gary. Gary coming along the stand side of the pitch, a short ball. Down towards Spellman. Spellman is fouled. Just held on to the jersey there. Number 7, Mikey Walton is hands full with Kate Spellman today. Probably one of the best fan of the match in the minor final. Kate playing well again today. Coming over to take this Spike Spellman. One of the greatest players ever to lift on the green and white of Mullingar Shamrocks. What a forward he's done. 25 years service to the club. And possibly more. 3-in. Spellman again is fouled. Looks like a foul in the back. Spellman going to take it himself. Left foot over here on the stand side of the pitch. Just outside the 21-yard line. Spellman strikes. And as usual, Spellman scores. But no doubt about it, this young man is a wonderful talent. An absolutely wonderful talent. Also, fine soccer player playing with Mullingar Athletic on the 21 side. That's Spellman playing for Mullingar Shamrocks today. Kicks the ball over the bar and makes it 5 points to 2 in favour of Mullingar Shamrocks after roughly 20 minutes of the first half. Under the conditions, I think this has been a fabulous game of football so far. Total wholehearted commitment from both sides. Out towards the centre of the field. Up goes Spike. Spike knocks it out of the grass. A Damien Gunning. Out to Paul Mulvaney. Mulvaney's still with the ball. Keegan again. Keegan has a lot of the ball in the first half and is using this tactic of straight into Summers the whole time. Very well intercepted there. Spike there to David Miller. That's his minor captain. Theatre. Spellman on along the stand side of the pitch. Takes on his man, beats him. Looks like a foul there. That got the ball, but well collected. Oh, and it's a set line ball in there, Summers. That's out by number 7 there, Michael Ward from Milltown. Spellman to pick the sideline ball. Spellman, a lot of movement off the ball here. Drives it down along the line. Darren Moore going to get the ball. Darren collects over here on the stand side of the pitch. 4 foot. He's two great feet. Knocks the ball in. Looks like it's coming to down, but it's nicely knocked out with the 45 from Mullingar Shamrocks. Knocked out by fullback Patrick Riley. Really had no option there. He was coming to Donovan. He went up for the ball. Riley knocked it clean out of his hand. Taking the 45 here. Spike Fagan. Spike winner, 8th championship medal with Mullingar Shamrocks. What a haul. 8th senior championship medal for the club. There's no player in Westmead has anything like it. It's a 12 goal. Drops down to the Collins can make connection with it. And coming out of it for Milton. Oh, it's blocked down again. Spellman. Spellman has it. He's under pressure though. Oh, he's made a great change of feet. Takes it. Oh, what a score. What a score from Peter Spellman. It looks like he was in all sorts of trouble. And he just slips a foot pass in around the corner back and knocks it over the bar. And Shamrocks establish a 4-point lead here. 21-22 minutes gone in this game so far. And really the difference has been the Mullingar Shamrocks forwards. They are just taking the scores. They're putting it better. But then again, it seems to me that they're playing with the breeze. Rain coming down very heavily now at the moment. Damien Bowen from Milton, about to take the kick out here. Damien, out towards the centre of the field. Who's going up first? Ah, Gunning again. Gunning is having a lording in at the middle of the field so far. Nobody seems to be able to catch the ball with him. Paddy O'Donnell slips out of the grasp of Francis McLaughlin into O'Donnell. High ball. High ball, but it's knocked on by John Gannon, but he's not. No one's going to make that on Patrick Gavigan. Oh, Gavigan, a very, very loose pass out towards the sideline. Doesn't keep it in play. Gavigan made a great interception there, but in the third, his pass was went slightly astray. And now Shamrocks are on the attack again. Spike with the ball. Terrace side of the pitch. Kicks it. In across. In towards John Gandy. Knocked out of his hands. But coming on to it, Michal Curley. Curley turns back around towards goal. Oh, and it's taken off by Willie Keegan. Well intercepted by Willie. And he's coming out with it again. Well done, Willie Keegan there. And he's knocked it out very well. Number 7, Michael Lord. Down along the line. Michael Dillon. He's got him behind Simon Cashman. Cashman gets back there. Cashman still has him. Still with him. Mickey looks like he's fouled. Yes, he is. Cashman just left the hand in too long. Mickey Dillon was clean through there at one stage, but very well got to by Simon Cashman. He just got to him in time because Michael Dillon was bearing down on goal at that stage. He just couldn't make the speed. Stephen Summers, 14 yards out. Oh, terrible bad kick. Very, very close. It came out by David Miller. Out to Spike Fagan. Spike coming down along the stand side of the pitch. Strikes. Oh, it slid off the boot and it's gone out over the sideline. Sideline ball to Milltown, number 7 for Milltown, Michael Ward. And he's kicked it straight back down over the sideline again. Milltown are wasting a lot of possession here. They've had every opportunity in this first half, but they're just not using enough of the football. Spellman making a run for the ball. Sideline to be taken by Spike again. Spike drives it. In high into the centre of the field. Not close. Who's coming out for it? Alan Connolly. Connolly picks it up. Connolly, he's a bit of a speed merchant. Outside of the boot. Going through John Danley. No, he won't make it. And coming out, Tommy Dillon. Tommy Dillon with the ball. Back to Tommy again. He's still gone. Still in Dillon. Milltown captain leading by example. Oh, it's slid off the right. And he's close on it. Heading towards the center, but it's well kept in. Danny Stalley. On the terrace side of the pitch. Knocks it through.
That's it through for number 15. Number 12, Francis McLaughlin. Gone over the sideline. Gone over the sideline. Milltown ball. Over across the goal. Spike goes up for it. Doesn't make it. Spike gets a hand to it again. Looks like it's going for 45. No, kept in by David Miller. Oh, very, very heavy challenge there on David Miller. Very, very heavy challenge of David Miller down at the gun scorer's end of the pitch. There's no sign of the ball there, and the Milton man just plowed into him. I think it's Stephen Summers. I can't see the number on the back of his jersey. But Miller looks like he's in big trouble. He hasn't moved since he went to ground. David Miller only coming back from a very serious injury. Kept him out of the semi-final. And a yellow card is given. Yellow card given to... I just can't see it. Number 10. Fergal Riley. Fergal Riley got the yellow card there. For a very hefty challenge. And David Miller is still on the ground. I'm sorry to say, but he hasn't moved from the minute he went down. And he still is lying prostrate on the ground. Getting up to his feet now. Still very shook looking. In around him there, Shamrock's teammates. Miller back on his feet after a very, very hefty challenge. It has to be said, this game hasn't been played dirty at all so far. Played in the spirit it should be played. Both teams going at it hell for leather. But that's been the first really hard challenge that was in it, and maybe he's just the conditions have just slid in a little bit too hard on it. We give him the benefit of the doubt. Darragh Ryan kicks it out. Towards the sideline and over the sideline. None of the Shamrocks players could keep it in play. And Milton will be on the attack again. 6 points to two here. 24, 25 minutes odd gone in the first half here. Willie Keegan. Willie knocks it in. Intercepted by Paddy O'Donnell. Going out to get it. Going out to get him, Mullingar Shamrock's number two, that's Owen O'Mara. O'Mara's fouled. It'll be a free kick to Shamrock on their own 14-yard line to be taken by Mihal Foley. Mihal, down along the side. Connelly goes for Justin Gain. Colum O'Donovan. O'Donovan goes down, but he doesn't collect the ball, and it's been out over the sideline again. Very hard to hold the ball here. Willie Keegan knocks it through. Francis McLaughlin. Keegan again. Keegan is all over the pitch here so far today. Short ball too. Knocked out. Tom Dillon. Dillon is fouled. Dillon is fouled again. Shamrock's committing an awful lot of fouls in around their own goal mark. And if they keep at this, Milton are going to punish them. So far, Shamrock's in the ascendancy by 6 points to two, but this could have the deficit between the sides. Short, but it's over the bar. Summers again, he scored all of Milton's scores so far, all from threes. Milton just yet to score from play, but it's early days yet. We're only in the first half. Good game so far, and there it is. The referee blows for half-time here in Cruiser Park. And at half-time in the Guinness-sponsored Westmead Junior Football Final for 2003, the score stands at Mullingar Shamrock 6 points, Milltown 3. Very heavy conditions here. Stephen Summers has scored all of Milltown's scores so far, all three of them. Mullingar Shamrock's Keane O'Leary got one, Spellman got two, Darren Moore with two, and Colum O'Donovan with the other one. 6 points to three at half-time. Low scoring game, but under the conditions, nothing more could be expected. Spike Fagan urging on the Mullingar Shamrock troops there. Spike won his first championship medal for Mullingar Shamrock before any other member of the team was born. That's the dedication this man has shown to the green and white of Mullingar. 43 years of age and still going at full pace. Amongst all these 18-19. Milton back out onto the field. A lot of work to do, but still there's only a kick of the ball between the teams. A goal for Milton and bring it back level. Shamrock's 3 points it to the good after the first half. Rain coming down very, very heavily here in Cruiser Park here today. It's a miserable day. but both teams serving up a good game of football so far. Number 11 there from Milton, Willie Keegan, probably the best player so far in the first half. Toss up to win himself, maybe himself and Damien running at the centre of the field, but Willie Keegan getting an awful lot of ball into him. Along with Mikey Dillon. Mikey Dillon having a great game at corner forward from Milton as well, giving Simon Cashman a lot of trouble. And Pod Green with the ball in his hands is about to throw it up for the second half here with the Gillarin sponsored junior football final 2003. And the ball is in. The game is on for the second half. First to the ball, Michal Curley, 17 years of age. What a talent this young man is. Drives it along. Into Peter Collins. Collins coming in on goal, driving straight on. Straight through again. Out to Alan Connolly. Connolly on the right foot. Kicks it. It's very high. Oh, it's in around the goal. Keeper has dropped it. He's got it again, though. Little bit lucky there, the goalkeeper, Damien Bowen, and Milton looks like. Yes, it's gone wide. Damien Bowen, though, the ball got straight out of his hands. Looked like for a time it was going over the bar, but it dropped into Damien. Damien dropped it out of his hands. There was no one coming in on the ball to strike it into the corner of the net. And Milton escape, a very, very lucky escape for Milton there. That could have been so much better for Mullingar Shamrocks. If anybody had been following in that ball, ball in from Alan Connolly, he was going for the score, I would say. It was higher, it looked like it was going over the bar, but dropped short. Damien Byrne dropped it over his grasp, and Damien will take the kick out now, looking to escape that. The ball went wide. No changes so far here. Still as we started on the programme. Damien, good kick out. Out towards the centre of the field. Number 10 for Milton grabs it. It's Fergal Riley. Fergal out to Damien Gunning. Gunning drives it along the ground, but it's intercepted by Spike Fagan. Spike knocks it up. Paddy O'Donnell. Cross field ball, but it goes to now and only Willie Keegan again. He's all over the pitch to go. Willie Keegan challenging for the ball. Paddy O'Donnell comes out with it. Paddy looks like he's going on a bit of a cul-de-sac. Gets the ball away, but he only gets it away as far as Damien Gunning. Gunning going down on the ball. Number 9, Paul Mulvaney. Mulvaney out to Ward. High ball shows it. Spike looks like he has it. Slips. Oh, and he's not the straight out of Mikey Dillon. Dillon with the ball in his hand. Strikes it off his left foot. Left and wide. That was very, very close. It looked like he was going over the bar. The umpires have waved it wide. Spike Fagan inadvertently knocked it across the square, and Mikey Dillon was almost clean through there once did. Dara Ryan to take the kick out. Dara out towards the stand side of the pitch. Well caught here. Number 10 for Milton coming into the game now. Fergal Riley out towards 15. Mikey Dillon, and Mikey Dillon has put it over the bar. Milton's first score from play to lead 2 between the sides. A good score from Mikey Dillon. 6 points to 4 here. The opening minute of the second half, giving Simon Cashman a lot of trouble out there on the far side of the pitch. He gave him a lot of trouble in the first half as well. Darren Ryan coming out to fix the ball here on the 21. Dara kicks it out. Out towards the centre of the field. Up for first team O'Leary, but it's well caught again. O'Reilly coming right into the game now. Knocks it through, but Simon Cashman looks like he's coming out with the ball. Cashman bends, picks up the ball. Very high challenge there by Damien Gunning. But Cashman stands up to the challenge, and out he comes with the ball again. Owen O'Mara hands it over to Spike. Spike now, out in the 40. He's playing very deep at the moment. Alan Connolly goes up for the ball. Connolly doesn't catch. Looks like a foul there. Looks like a foul on Keane O'Leary. What is the referee going to do here? Linesman is given a line ball. It looked like a foul on Keane O'Leary. O'Leary is still down injured. He's had a lot of injuries this year. And it's given as a line ball to Milton. Willie Keane coming with the ball. Thomas got to defend here. Out again, Mikey Dillon. Simon Cashman going after him. Dillon again. He's Milton's target man so far here in this game. Dillon strikes with the left foot. But it's gone very, very wide. Left-hand side and very, very wide. Mikey had men out and amongst them there. He could have passed it out, but he decided to go for his own score. Unfortunately, he drifted just to the left and right. Darragh Ryan. Shamrocks really haven't gotten going in the second half, and it's been virtually all Milltown so far in this second half. Still only 2 points between the sides. Mullingar, Shamrocks, 6 points, Milltown, four. Darragh Ryan out towards the terrace side of the pitch. Drops down. Willie Keegan again. He's having a storm of a game from Milltown. Up goes David Miller. Miller catches, collects, drives out with the ball, and he's fouled. Well held, David Miller. Knocks it out towards the wing. Out to strike. Looks like he was clipped around the ankles there, and it's a free out to strike. Strike with the ball. Knocks it over the top. Into Spellman. Spellman has got round his man again, as he has done so far all this game. Spellman looks like he's fouled, and he is. Spellman over on the terrace side of the pitch. Direct ball into Peter Collins. Collins hasn't gotten his game yet so far, and he's dropped it again. Coming out with a Patrick Gavigan. Oh, a little bit of foostering and fumbling with it there. Again, looks like Gavigan again. Out towards the centre of the field. Paddy O'Donnell looks like he's going to collect this one. Oh, and he drops it just at the right of moment, and he gets it back again. But a foul, John Donnelly fouled off the ball there. Paddy O'Donnell was clean away with that ball, and John Donnelly made the foul. Needless foul by John Ganley. Shamrocks looked like they were going on the attack again. William Keegan kicks it out towards the stand side of the pitch. Up for it. Everybody goes for it. No one gets it, but going down in it now is Spike Fagan. Hefty shoulder, but he's coming out with the ball. Knocks it out. Miller. Miller spins it. Stephen Summers with the ball. Out again, number six. Into the corner again. Out again to Summers. Summers, he's in tight in the corner. There are three Shamrocks men around him, but he's made light it off. But he's over-carried the ball. He's over-carried the ball, and it'll be a free out to Mullingar Shamrocks. Right down in the corner of the pitch here at the apartment's end. Out towards the centre of the field. More of the rougher. Spilled in the centre of the field, but he's collected it back again. McLaughlin. Into number 10. Fergal Riley, Fergal into the corner to Danny Scully. Danny on the right foot across the square. It's dangerous ball. Oh, couldn't get a foot to it and coming out with it. David Miller made a great interception there. Out to Paddy. Paddy O'Donnell out over the sideline and a Milltown ball. All the pressure coming at the start of this second half from the Milltown team. Shamrocks really haven't gotten going at all in this second half. Very poor start so far, and Milton piling on the pressure here at the start of the second half after about 6-7 minutes of the second half. Low ball. Mikey Dillon goes for it. Doesn't get it this time. Willie Keegan again. Knocks it out. Paddy O'Donnell intercepts. O'Donnell with the shoulder. Connelly can't pick it up. Coming out to it now. Michael Ward. It's not Michael Ward. It's Aidan Scally. Aidan Scally again. Scally with the ball. Kicks it. High. In towards the goal. Looks like it's coming to Spike again. Spike is defending very deeply. Out to number 6, Mihal Curley at centre half-back. Curley striding down the field. Needs to get it longer. He's going to lose it. Mihal Curley passing it out. John Ganley into Paddy. Paddy O'Donnell. The Pops kicks it high. It's very high in towards Peter Collins. He's not going to get there. And coming out with it, number 2, the Milltown captain, Tom Dillon. Tommy Dillon strikes it off the right foot. Looks like it's heading towards the sideline, but it's well kept in. Fergal Riley in towards the goal again. Oh, pushing it back, and Spike is injured. Spike is badly injured. He came right into the back of him there. Stephen Summers came right into the back of him. No attempt at the ball. Came right in behind him. Spike looks as if he's okay. Combination, it could have been David Miller might have been involved in that tackle as well. Could have been his own man that struck him that time, but definitely Stephen Summers was coming out from the goals, and he seemed to make a bit of a connection there, but Spike is all right. He's back on his feet. Spike looks like he's defending in the second half. He looks like he's playing as a seventh defender. Maybe not the greatest tactic for Summers, trying to defend a two-point lead, but however, the ball continues. Game continues. Keegan O'Leary out. Gary Moore going for it. Will he get it? No, he doesn't. It's a line ball to Mullingar Summers. Kicked out by a Milton man. And the referee has changed the decision and he's given the ball to Milton. Linesman definitely given away this one. It's high ball. In towards Summers again. Summers grabs again. David Miller. Looks like he's fouled him and he is. Summers has a chance now to just put the minimum between the sides. on the terrace side of the pitch. Stephen Summers with a chance to just put 1 point between the side. Milton made a very, very bright start in the second half. Played all the football so far with the aid of the wind. Mullingar Shamrocks really haven't gotten going at all in the second half. Very poor start. They need to get going if they're going to win this junior title for the first time since 1962. Milltown looking for the first title since 96. It's out to the right and wide again. Stephen Summers has kicked some very bad wide today from a young man I expected to play an awful lot better.
Milltown substitution number 18, Michael Connell.
And coming in at number 18 for Milltown is Michael Connell. Michael Connell coming in at number 18, replacing number 7, Michael Ward. He's had a torrid time on Peter Spellman all day. Milltown have made the switch. Michael Connell coming in, number 18, replacing number 7, Michael Ward. Ball out towards the centre of the pitch. Paddy and I'll make a go for it. Not going to get there, but it's a ball in. The line ball is to Shamrocks anyway. Out towards the centre of the pitch. Curley gets it. Curley powering through. No one coming to meet him. Mihal still going. Out to the corner. Darren Moore. Darren looks like he's not going to make it either. Tommy Dillon coming out. Darren fouled him into the back of him. Mikey Dillon having a cracking game. Actually, Tommy Dillon, he's having a cracking game. Out towards the centre field. No one near Paul Mulvaney at all. He's all on his own. Down along the side. Knocked out by Owen O'Mara. It's gone out over the sideline here on the stand side of the pitch. On the 21-yard line, it'll be a sideline ball for Milltown here. Willie Keegan to kick the ball. Willie out here on the stand side of the pitch. Striking with the right foot. Willie, what's he going to do? He knocks it right across the square. It's very high, gets a hand to it, but coming out again is Spice, that seventh defender. He's said it already. It looks like Shamrocks are playing a holding game so far. Out to Spellman. Spellman, Michael Connell gets the first ball. Well done, Michael Connell. He's just into the game. He's made a good interception. Out towards the centre of the field. Mulvaney has it. Mulvaney standing at his own 40-yard line. Challenge gets in, but the ball is kicked away. Kicked away down towards... And it's Simon Cashman coming out with the ball. Cashman getting it hard to hold on to it, but he drives it down along the field into Peter Collins. Collins just hasn't got to the pitch of the game so far today. Again he misses his tackle. Out to the centre of the field again. No. O'Mara again. O'Mara loses it. Into Willie Keegan, the danger man from Milltown. Willie Keegan knocks it into the full forward, Stephen Summers. Summers out towards the terrace side, makes an angle for himself, knocks it across the square. Loose man, all on his own. Knocks it past. Danny Scully is in on goal. No one coming to him. Can he get a strike? He does, but he puts it absolutely wide. Wide as wide can be. He had a great chance there. No one from Mullingar Shamrocks coming to meet him. And Danny Scully has kicked a very, very poor wide. Milton completely in the ascendancy here at the start of the second half. Mullingar Shamrocks really haven't gotten going at all. It's been a very poor start to this second half. Not getting into it at all. Looks like Mullingar Shamrocks are warming up a sub. Mark McLaughlin looks like he's coming into the game. Mark McLaughlin and David Bell, two of this year's minor team. McLaughlin had a superb second half for Mullingar Shamrocks in the minor final. David Bell played at wing half back in the minor semi-minor final. He had a great game that day as well. Out over the head of O'Leary. O'Leary going for it. O'Leary puts the foot to it, but doesn't get it. It breaks loose. It breaks loose. Damien Gunning. Oh, bad pass, but it stopped again. And it's a free to Gunning anyway. Willie Keegan. 45, out on the 45. Willie with the ball in hand. Will he go for a score? Will he drop it around the goals? Hard to know. He has the wind behind. He could possibly make it. Willie kicks with the right foot. It's a very high ball, but it's very high and wide. Milton wasting an awful lot of opportunity here at the start of the second half. But really, if they were taking the scores, they should be at level 10, but possibly not, just a little bit ahead of Mullingar Shamrocks. Shamrocks just not getting going at the start of this second half. It's been a poor start to the second half for Shamrocks, and they've got to lift it. They've got to lift it if they're going to lift their first junior title since 1962. Poor kick out from down the line, and it goes straight to Mulvaney. Mulvaney going through, he picks it. Blast is wide. Oh, that's a terrible wide. He had men outside him. He had people moving off the ball for him, and instead he decides to kick himself, and he has ballooned it wide. Ned Moore coming on now. He's trying to urge on his troops. They really haven't gotten going at all yet. It's been a desperately poor start in the second half by Mulligar Shamrocks, who had virtually all the play in the first half. Totally dominant, but this wind is causing a bit of trouble. Outside the centre, John Ganley. No, picked up. Owen O'Mara. O'Mara spills it again. Spills it a second time. It's out under the feet of a lot of players there. Coming out spiked again. Carnally, but he drops it. He drops it. Michael Ward spills again. Oh, Willie Keegan, he's having a storm of a game here. Knocked across the pitch. Cashman going over. Mikey Dillon. Mikey with the ball. Charging into Simon Cashman. He kicks. He kicks. And it's gone wide again. Another opportunity. Absolutely wasted here by Milton. They are really kicking some atrocious wides. It's a poor return for all the possession that they have. Shamrock's not able to get a grip at the centre of the field. Spike Fagan looks as if he's playing as an extra defender. They're getting no ball around the centre of the field. They're not pushing on. No score yet in the second half for Mullingar Shamrock's, but it's still 6 points to four. A great pass. Damien Gunning coming through. Gunning strikes with the right foot. This time it's going over the bar. A great score for Damien Gunning. And that leaves the minimum between the sides. A great score. It's been coming for a long time now. Milltown completely on top. Ball out quickly down the line. Out towards Owen O'Mara. O'Mara up along the sideline. Fouled after the ball. Free kick. Colin O'Donovan leaves it there. Leaves it there. And to take the free kick, Spike Fagan again. Spike with the ball. Short into the corner. Looking for Spellman the whole time, but Spellman can't grab it. And again, it's out over the sideline. And Milltown again are on the attack. Number 17 coming in for Milltown now. Ollie Rogers. Ollie Rogers, a former inter-county star with Westmead. Ollie Rogers coming on for Danny Scully. He took a bit of an off game around there in the second half. And Ollie Rogers coming in at corner forward for Milltown. Spike with the ball, knocks it in towards the score, but there's absolutely nobody there. Coming clean out, Tom Dillon. Michael Furley gets a hand to it, knocks it over towards Gary Moore. Gary is pushed in the back, and it'll be a free in to Mullingar Shamrocks. Michael Furley, short, into Spellman. What can Spellman do? Can he pull it out of the fire like he did in the minor final 2 weeks ago? Spellman, on to the right foot, moving in. He still has the ball. He's looking for a man outside. He's still holding on to it, Spellman. Knocks it across the square. A good ball. Carnally. Carnally gets loose. Carnally gets loose. Knocks it across the square. A goal for Mullingar Shamrocks. Keane O'Leary. Keane O'Leary gets his hand to the ball. And it's a goal. A goal for Keane O'Leary. Floated across the square from Alan Carnally. O'Leary got the hand to it and he buried it into the corner in it. He gave Damien Bell no chance with that whatsoever. And Mullingar Shamrocks, having played no football at all in the second half, now find themselves 4 points to the good. Up towards the centre of the field. Coming straight through. Mikey Dillon. Mikey into Summers. Summers has the ball and put the goal. Driving through Damien Gunning. Could this be Ollie Rogers' goal? No! Great save, Dara. Great save, Dara Ryan. A great move. A good move there by Milltown. Darryline made the interception. Michael Curley, no one with him. Got to get rid of it. Rising up along the sideline. No one there, only Paul Mulvaney from Milltown. He's got a man inside. That man inside is... Well, Spike coming out of the ball. Knocks it loose. Simon Cashman. Great ball out. Paddy O'Donnell coming up along the stand side of the pitch. Drops it, but Fly picks it. And the rugby turns. Paul Mulvaney again. Cornerback Patrick Gavigan. Gavigan outside of the booth, heading towards the sideline. I don't think even Willie Keegan is having a great game. I don't think even Willie will keep that in. Number 19 coming on. Number 19 coming on. That's Paul Mahan. Paul Mahan coming on to the Milltown side. Another youngster.
Substitution number 19, Paul Mahan.
Can't see who he's replacing at the moment. It looks like Francis McLaughlin. Looks like Francis McLaughlin, and it is. Oh, a terrible bad sideline. And straight into the play. The substitute after coming in, Paul. Paul Mahan. Ball through. Mikey Dillon is fouled again. Dillon just outside the halfway between the 21 to 45. Coming out to take it, Stephen Summers. Summers not on the game so far with the free kicking duties. Can he put one kick of the ball between the sides? This would leave it with just 3 points. This would leave it at 3 points. Summers strikes with the right. Summers strikes. And it's over the bar. Another point for Stephen Summers. He scored all bar one. Sorry, all bar two. Damien Gunning has got one and Michael Dillon has got one. Summers has got four, all from free kicks. And the score now stands at Mullingar Shamrocks 1-6, Milltown 6 points. The goal from Kian O'Leary is the only difference between the sides at the moment. O'Leary with an opportunist goal out this side of the field. Looks like it's drifting towards the sideline. Connelly gets it, keeps it in play. Goes out over the sideline and it's a Mullingar Shamrocks ball out over the sideline. Connelly couldn't get to it, but neither could the Milltown man, and he's knocked it over. Paddy O'Donnell out towards the centre of the field. Curley, drop for Michael Dillon, high challenge, and Curley is gone with the ball. Leon Curley having a hard game this evening. Hard game today. John Ganley, actually Colin O'Donovan. O'Donovan, high towards goal. In over everybody, comes to O'Leary again. Blasted wide! Great chance for Keane O'Leary. He possibly could have just knocked that over the bar, put 4 points between him again. Bit of a mix-up in the Milltown defence. Nobody knew who was going for it in the end. Nobody did go for it. Came to O'Leary, bearing down on goals. He struck with the left foot, but left it out at the corner flag, drove it right across the goals. Could have been a second goal for Mullingar Shamrocks, but having said that, Shamrocks are coming back into it a little bit here. They've had none of the play for the first 10 or 12 minutes of this second half, but now they're coming into it a little bit, beginning to play a bit of football. Connelly goes up. Drops it, Paddy O'Donnell. Colin O'Donovan, no. Taken now, clean out of his hands. Great interception, but Spike has it. Spike has it on the stand side of the pitch. Spike lobs it up. Paul O'Donovan. Ball got out over the sideline. Patrick Riley. Drives it to the centre, but it's intercepted by Paddy O'Donnell, and Paddy knocks it over the sideline. Ball very slow. It's very hard to grasp here at the moment. Mikey Dillon, Milton star performer, has to be said here so far. High ball, in towards the goal, but out comes again with Spike Fagan. Spike is having an absolutely brilliant game so far. In over the head of them all. Keane O'Leary goes for it, but he won't make it. Coming out, Patrick Riley. Oh, he spins it out towards Dillon, running. Going up along the stand side of the pitch, knocks it out here, number 5, Aidan Scally. Scally is out over the line, and it's a sideline ball to Mullingar Shamrocks. Alan Connelly to take it. Connelly in towards goal. Caught by Fiacus Feldman. Hasn't gotten going in the second half. Good substitution, Michael Conlon in on him. Down into the corner of the pitch. Feldman still going through though. He's straight through on goals. Feldman kicks and puts it wide. He put it wide, he had a great chance there, two men outside him. Maybe could have passed, it was a very, very difficult angle, and we have an injury here to a Mullingar Shamrocks player. It looks like Keane O'Leary, he was down earlier, and it looks like he's down again. In fact, it's not gone wide, it's a 45 to Mullingar Shamrocks. A 45 to Mullingar Shamrocks, and it looks like Mark McLaughlin, number 22 for Mullingar Shamrocks, coming into the game. Who is he going to replace? Possibly for Keane O'Leary. He looks like he's injured.
Mullingar Shamrock substitution number 22, Mark McLaughlin.
Mark McLaughlin coming in. Who's going off? Peter Collins. Collins going off. He really didn't get the pitch for the game so far, but this is a fine young footballer and a great hurler with the Oliver Trumpets Hurling Club as well. Peter Collins. Coming off the pitch to be replaced by Mark McLaughlin. Peter already with a minor football championship medal. Unfortunately lost the hurling final last week with Oliver Plunkett. But now Mark McLaughlin into the game. Spike with the 45. Kicks it high. Over to where McLaughlin has just got to come onto the pitch. And McLaughlin is fouling. First thing he does in the game is create a foul, and Milton will have the kick out. Over on the terrace side of the pitch. Almost around the goals. Patrick Riley, out towards the centre field. Looks like Patrick coming to it. Gets a hand to it, but it doesn't go. It goes to Mikey Dillon. Dillon, into Mulvaney. No, it's not Mulvaney in fact. Fergal Riley kicks it in towards goal. Caught. Caught, held up. Held up, number 19 there. Number 19 is Paul Mahon. Paul Mahon, Stephen Summers now. Chance to put 2 points between the sides. He's on the 45. He has the wind behind him. Can he use it to his advantage? Summers kicks with the right foot. Looks like it's just as the right, but it's not gone. No, it's still not gone. Coming over to David Miller. Miller on the ground. Simon Cashman goes for it. Milton have it. Milton have it in around the goal. No, and he can't use it. Ollie Rogers with the ball. Ollie kicks it across the goal. There's three Milton men in here for it. None of them get it so far. Comes back out. Number 18, Paul Mahoney off the coming out of the field. Again, it's high, locked in. And a goal for Milton! A goal for Milton! Number 10 for Milton, Fergal Riley has got the goal and it's level scores. Level scores, 1-6 apiece. A highly opportunist lobbing ball, looks like Norman's goal for it. But Fergal Riley has fisted it to the back of the Mullingar Shamrocks net. And it's level scores, and to be fair, it's no more than Milton deserved. They've been completely dominant for the second half of this game. Absolutely dominant so far. Mullingar Shamrocks not really getting to the pitch of the game. And Milton really beginning to come on top again. It probably was a lucky goal, more lucky than the Mullingar Shamrocks goal. A fisted pass to the back of the net, and we're all square in Kilsey Park. Ollie fouled at the centre of the field. Keane O'Leary is fouled at the centre of the field. Spike to take the free. Spike drives it up over the top. Darren Moore going for it. Warren Nathan coming out for it. Milton's bad performer so far. Tommy Dillon, the captain of the Milton side, looking for his second junior medal. Knocked down. Spike has it. No, he hasn't. It's on the ground. Ollie Rogers picked straight up off the ground. Straight up off the ground by Fergal Riley, and Shamrocks have the ball again. Spike Fagan. Far side of the field and off the ball. Hobbs Green calling over Gary Moore. It looks like Gary Moore. And Gary could be in serious trouble here. There's a Milton man lying on the ground. It hasn't been a dirty game so far, but Gary definitely was seen doing something by the referee. He called him over immediately. There's a Milton man lying prostrate on the ground. Jim Dalton over to him. He hasn't got the card out yet. Is it yellow or is it going to be red? That a man sent off in the minor final. Pod Green is going to the back pocket. I have a feeling this could be a red card. It's a red card! And Gary Moore is gone. Gary has been sent off. Referee obviously seeing something going on off the ball. And Shamrocks back down to 14 men. Hard being the referee. He's seen what happened. There's no doubt about it. Gary Moore down to the line. Shamrocks down to 14 men. At a crucial time, a very silly sending off. It looked like the referee there for striking. He made the action that it was a striking offence. Now Shamrocks get Ben and Donnie coming through with the ball. Passing out, but it's intercepted by Paddy O'Donnell. And O'Donnell drives it out over the sideline on the far side of the field. Milton on the attack again. Milton holding all the aces there after getting back to level score. There's an extra man. In towards the goals again. High ball. Mihal fairly under it, but he doesn't get it. Comes out. One of the Milton substitutes. Striking at goal across the square, but there's Ryan there on his spike. Spike coming out of the ball. He's fouled. Spike coming out. No one moving for him at all. Drives it out towards Mihal Curley. Curley out towards the centre of the field. Mihal driving forward, picks it out this side of the pitch. Who's going to make it?
Darren Moore is not going to make it. Tom Dillon makes it. And straight through, a great pass in. Into number five, Aidan Scully. Scully storming forward. Into Willie Keegan. Keegan into 17, Ollie Rogers. Rogers going through with the ball. He's not fouled, he's not fouled. Willie Keegan gets a kick at it. And it's over the bar. Milton has gone into the lead. Willie Keegan, a great score. He's been Milton's star performer all day, there's no doubt about it. And he goes back, he puts Milton into the lead for the first time in the game. 1-7, 1-6. O'Leary, a great catch. Fouled by Keegan, it was a high challenge. What is Pad Green going to do this time? O'Leary's still on the ground. Shamrock's down to 14 men. Coming into the game is David Bell, the number 17 from Mullingar Shamrock. He can't come on now to play his target. He can't come on to the field. He's got to get off again. Spellman storming through. Spellman loses the ball. He loses it. Great interception. Coming through Milltown again. Paul Mahon, the Milltown sub, rising across the field, but it's intercepted by Owen O'Mara. O'Mara into Curley. Curley around his man, driving, bearing down on goal. Meanwhile, still going with the ball. Into Paddy O'Donnell. Paddy out with the right foot. Out towards the far side of the field. Keane O'Leary. Keane coming through. He stopped for a second. Into the corner. Mark McLaughlin. Back to O'Leary. A good ball, a great ball. And it's gone wide. Huh? The game is in stoppage time. We're in stoppage time. And it looks like Milltown hang on. They just need to hang on surely now for another couple of seconds. And the junior title is theirs for the first time since 1996. Shamrocks couldn't just hold on to the lead at halftime. John Danley, it looks like John Danley coming off. We're into added time. Surely there can't be a whole lot of that. It looks like the clip is going back to Milton. Ball out there, still playing. A great pass in the centre of the field. Knocks it back out. Ball out towards the centre of the field. Simon Cashman goes for it. Simon Cashman gets a hand to it. Into on O'Mara. O'Mara, possibly Mullingar's last chance. Oh, it's a terrible kick. And coming out, oh, he's picked it clean off the ground. I don't know about that one. I thought he went for the ball. It was a rolling ball. Meanwhile, Curley with the ball. Surely Shamrock's last attack. Curley into Keane O'Leary. Keane has it out on the terrace side of the pitch. He drives it in a corner. There's a fist on it. Oh, and it's just gone out. Oh, that was so close. It's gone for 45. This could possibly be the last kick of the game. It's gone for 45. That was so close. I think it might have even been Colin O'Donovan who got his hand to the ball and it just barely went past the post. Spike with the 45. Drives it in towards goal. There's a clatter of players coming out of it. Oh, it's wide left down. David Bell. Bell gets it. No, he doesn't. It. Milton man coming out of it. Milton have it again. They're going to clear it. It looks like they're going to clear it. No, they got a hand in. No, it's coming out again. And Colin Rogers. Ali, centre of the field. Coming down the stand side of the field. Ali, bringing it, holding on, making sure time is ticking away. Rogers, across the goal. But Cashman has it. No, he has it. Stephen Summer has it. And it's into the goal. Johnny Dillon is over the bar. It's over the bar. And Milton got 2 points into the lead. The game is up. I think the game is up and perfectly sure should be. Mikey Dillon gets the last score in the game. And Milltown are the 2003 Junior Football Champions of Westmead. The Junior Championship will go to Milltown after a load of 7 years. A very young side. Shamrocks just could not hold on. A staggering finish here, a goal with a fisted pass with 2 minutes to go. And then a point from Fergal Riley, put them in, a goal from Fergal Riley, a point from Willie Keegan, and the final score from Mikey Dillon. After said it should be Mikey. He was definitely Milltown star man today. Between himself and Millie Keegan, Shamrocks too had some star performance, but they just couldn't do it on the day. A very young, inexperienced apart from Spike Fagan Shamrocks side, and I'm sure their day will come again. They already have a minor title to the good. They just couldn't do it today, and no one in Mullingar Shamrocks would begrudge Milltown their title. They worked long and hard for it. They had a very tough semi-final against St. Paul's. They came through that one. Paul's probably would have been the favourites. Shamrocks beat St. Joseph's, probably the ultimate favourites to win this general championship. But on the day today, on a miserable day here in Kilsyth Park, the honours go to Milltown, 1-8 to 1-6. Shamrocks with only one score in the second half. A goal from Keane O'Leary was the only score they got. They really didn't go at the Milltown defence as they should possibly in the second half. But a powerful second half performance by Milltown. A super second half led by cornerback and captain Tommy Dillon. What a game he had for Milltown today. He was just outstanding. Couldn't get to grips. Other full back line, Patrick Riley, Patrick Devlin with a super game. Aidan Scally at wing half back had a stormer. Damien Gunning at the centre of the field had a great score in the second half. He had a fabulous game. Fergal Riley, Willie Keegan, possibly vying with Tom Mikey Dillon for man of the match. He played out of his skin today, and he had to, because this was a good game of football in very, very testing conditions. Very, very testing conditions. And Tommy Dillon, Ollie Rogers there. He's a long time servant, played with the St. Lawrence Club as well, played with Westmead. He's a long servant. Himself and Spike Fagan would remember each other. I'm sure they played against each other on many occasions. A great day for the Milltown Club, and there'll be some celebrating and gunning for our comrades for tonight, tomorrow night, and probably the whole of next week. There won't be a cow milk. So here it is, ladies and gentlemen. Tommy Dillon, the Milltown captain, coming up to collect the Junior Cup for 2003 on behalf of the Milltown team. It's been 7 long years waiting for it, but at last the silverware is heading back to Milltown. They've won the Junior Championship. They've won the Junior Championship for 2003.
I'd like to thank the referee and his linesman and umpires for doing a fine job. And I'd also like to welcome here representative sponsors, there is both Mr. Sean Flanagan, who of course is a former Milltown star. I'm sure it's fitting that his own club are the victors of the first general sponsor.
I just cannot be in a proud place today, boys and women, to lift this for ye. It's not just for the players, it's for the whole of the parish. I was just drove up and down through the parish of Milltown last week. There was green and white everywhere. It was fucking everywhere. Behind the scenes for Midtown to get us here today was just unbelievable. Just turn around and look at the way we were talked out today, boys. All our sponsors, especially to Mick Finn Plant Hire. He's here every year without fail. Always, whenever he's asked, no problem at all. It's not just him, there's other sponsors as well. You're not forgot. And I'd like to thank Johnny Gertie, our new chairman. First of all, our mentors, money for them, we're an offer. We have Ned Summers. We have Jerry Summers. And Barrister Martley! Them boys had us training in the wind and the rain and the cold. And look where we are today. They even had a cup of day o'clock on Sunday morning. We didn't mind. What we have this year, we didn't mind. In every game, there's winners, there has to be a loser. For us today, we're winners. Well and truly. But I'd like to say three cheers to Mullingar. They won the minor final. They're a very young team. Our own side is not too old either. For a few exceptions. No doubt, Mullingar, the future of them looks good. They'll have their day, I can guarantee it. So I'd like to say three cheers for Mullingar. Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip! With the looks of things, there's not so many left in Midtown. And it's going to be a while before we get home as well. With the helmet on, we have a serious night ahead.
a very special gentleman here. A man who's Milltown to the backbone, and today he's a main sponsor for the Junior Intermediate Championship, John Flanagan. John.
How are you, Ollie?
It's nice to be involved, and especially when Milltown have taken a Junior Championship.
Absolutely, and it was a good year for us to pick, and nice to see Milltown come in, and our other friend Ballymore got Intermediate, so we had a great day out of it.
Before we touch on the game itself, sponsorship, Sean, what does this mean to Sean Flanagan, to Danny Burns and Gillerans?
Well, I suppose it's nice to put something back into the game. I got a lot out of it. Can't play anymore, so I suppose the best thing you can do is throw a few bob in. I know Tom Farrell and a few of the boys inside in County Board for years, so it's nice to throw something in.
Milltown went in today. It's underdogs for this one today, Sean. They came out with strength in their power strength. They were in trouble for a lot of the time, but at the end they finished the stronger, Sean.
Absolutely fabulous finish. It's great to see a young team with such composure and finish so strongly. Bad goal given away, at an unlucky goal maybe some would say, but they kept their heads and won very, very well, and it's complimentary to them all, team and manager.
Well, look, Sean, we let you get home with the celebrations now. What can we say? Any thank you for what you're doing for the GAA, and once again on behalf of everyone, congratulations to Milltown for making us Junior Champions 1993.
Absolutely, thanks.
2003. Sorry, 2003, Sean.
Yeah.
We're older than that.
My time, yeah.
Sean Flanagan, thank you very much.
Good luck.
Celebrations have begun here in Danny Burns. We have two gentlemen quite happy to take time off to have a few words. Stephen Cahillan and Donny Whelan. Stephen, happy man this evening.
Absolutely thrilled with
some finish today.
Absolutely great, and it's really a credit to such a bunch of young lads, and it's really something to look forward to, I think, going forward into the intermediate grade with such a young team. I couldn't be happier.
Well, one of Gareth Shambers, we're talking about this young team today, but at the end of the day, the bit of experience stood out at the end, Stephen.
It did, I suppose, and really, people might be talking about man of the match, and you could name three or four players, and I suppose, really, it does go back to the experience. I think Tom Dillon was, as a player, the captain of the party, was unreal at the back there today, outstanding defender. Damien Gunn in the middle of the field really had a fabulous game as well. Bill Keegan, I thought, did a lot of work around the middle. And then we'll go on to the young fellas like Fergal O'Reilly, and they really did the business as well. Fergal had a huge last 15 or 20 minutes, and I think he held the ball to the net for the decisive goal there that helped me come back into it.
It took you a little while to wear down Shamrocks at the same time, but when you got going, you didn't, the first half, now you were quite enough, but in the second half when the team got going, it was on the cards, it was going to be
very really took the way. Game. They did, really took the game, the Shamrocks. I think Shamrocks got down the field twice nearly in the second half. Now they got maybe two scores when they got down there. They got a goal at a crucial time for them, and I thought it might carry them to victory, a flick on there, and probably a very good goal. But I think a tribute to probably Martin Lynn and the Midtown mentors, that these young players dug deep and fought back. Sometimes they might have buckled under that and said, this is not our day, but I think today they really, really dug deep and they came back for a fabulous finish.
Once again, Stephen, what can we say on you? Congratulations, well done, and long may the celebrations last.
Thanks, Ollie. Thanks,
and a man that has put a lot of those lads through his hands, Donald Whelan. Donald.
I enjoyed every minute of that game. I watched fellas that had gone through school with me. But what my enjoyment out of that was watching what was on the line. There was another 10 or 15 young lads there, and that's the future of our club. That impressed me so much, and every fella is willing to get out there and give his best. But to see the youth, I can see the future. Our community centre is nearly finished. We have a fabulous pitch. An awful lot of work has gone on through the years, and this is culminating in this now.
Well, Don, as you mentioned there, it is great to see the youth coming through, and it's very important.
I think
Milltown have been down the last couple of years, depending on some of the older stages.
Yeah.
But in fairness to those lads, they kept the thing going when it was needed to keep going.
I have to say one thing, Ollie Rogers' run to the corner impressed me really big time. Towards the end there, he ran to the corner flag, and I said, the young lad would have kicked that ball, and it might have come back. But Ollie, they're like Demming going fantastic game as well. And Mikey Dillon and Tom Dillon. Tom Dillon, and I have to give credit to Spike Fagan as well. Tom and Spike, I have to say, played the same role. And up to then.
I have to say,
great credit. I mean, you just enjoy it. Junior football has improved immensely. When you look at that game today, it was the cleanest game you'd see. Football's a low-play football.
Well, you must be proud of the lads as you put through your own hands, Don.
Oh, without doubt. And there's more of them to come. And there are loads of them to come. And Stephen, the two lads are going to talk about it shortly. Hopefully. I mean, it's a lovely atmosphere there now. And I have to say that Mullen Oligo is struggling to you, as the fellow said. And that's my belief of it. And Stephen's the same.
Donald.
And Milton have that now. And that's their future.
Donald, we'll leave it at that. I have to take you away from nice refreshments and things there. All I can say is congratulations to both yourself and Stephen there, and a job well done.
And I'll also say to you, Ollie, thanks very much for your help. We do appreciate it tonight.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Very well done. Well, now we have a gentleman, and I'm sure he's a proud man this evening. In 96, he trained them to win the Juniors Championship. Today, he's the selector on the team, Eddie Summers. Eddie, it's a great feeling to be back intermediate again.
Oh, it is. There's no doubt about it. If you told me at the start of the year that we would pull off a junior championship in 2003, I wouldn't have thought it possible, because we had a very, very young team. And along the way, we said, I thought it might be a year or so too early for them. But we still stuck with them. And like we did a Houdini in the junior championship this year. There was everybody was talking about everybody, but nobody was talking about Milltown. So,
well, they're county champions this evening, and that's what counts. And great credit to those young lads and some of the more experienced players that carried the whole thing through there.
Unbelievable! The guys went out today, and Mullingar got a goal, and on Bannistoura, Martin Lynn came walking down the line after the goal going in, and I said to him, Martin, don't worry, there's still a goal in our side. I said, there is. I know there is. And there was.
Well, they certainly didn't panic on the side then, because you were under pressure a bit there at the start of the second half, but then things began to fit together. A lot of scores missed today, Eddie, and you would be kicking yourself if you had lost this game.
Yes, we would. And the scores, there was a lot of wides kicked, and I feel, with the young team we were playing, and as everybody is aware, we had a tremendous year, and all them young lads are playing on very fast, dry pitches with a ball that will do exactly what they ask it to do. And today is actually the first day, I think, since last, I don't know, I'd say it was last March, since they kicked the ball on a wet day. And there's no doubt about it, they just lack that little bit of experience with a wet ball. But having said that, we were creating the chances, we made the chances, and eventually we converted enough of them to come out victors here tonight.
Eddie, I won't take it away from the celebrations any longer. What can we say when congratulations and well done, and a job well done?
Thank you very much, Ollie.
Eddie Summers, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Congratulations to all the young lads. They're an absolute, we said it before, there was, I went away from the senior team, the senior involvement in the last few years to underage, and I got huge enjoyment out of underage. But them young lads out there gave me almost as much enjoyment as the young lads under 12s and under 14s. They're an absolute joy to work with, and they're a credit to themselves, they're a credit to their club, and they're a credit to their families. I could not praise them enough.
Well, we're not going to, just on a point there of underage, and I was going to bring it in a bit earlier. After the disappointment of the minor final, it's great to see that some of those lads have brought off a junior one.
Absolutely. I mean, You know, we didn't harp on the minor thing at all. We left them. We went back to the park. We did what we wanted to do, and it came off. You see the results today. The results are, like as I say, it's mind-boggling, really.
Eddie Summers.
In 1 year.
What can we say? Once again, congratulations, and the best of celebrations for the rest of the week.
And I can tell you, Ollie, we will celebrate it.
Eddie Summers, thank you very much.
All right.
Well, from one Summers to another, from one selector to another, Jerry Summers. Jerry, you're a proud man this evening.
There's no doubt about it, Ollie. There's no doubt about it. I'm the proudest coach now today. Not only because I probably had a young fella working on the first ball forward, but to think that we got that far. We were as proud as coach to get into the final. Just to get into the final. But to think that we're after winning it is unbelievable. With a young team.
You mentioned the young lad. Your man was full forward, is that right?
He was full forward.
And he had the disappointment of being beaten in the minor final this year.
That's
so
right.
I'm sure in the Summers household, you're happy this evening.
We're as happy as, I don't know what to say now. It's just unbelievable now.
It probably is sweeter to him now than the minor one.
Of course
sure.
It is. I know what it is because he doesn't hear on the net, it's only football and what either I done or Eddie done in our past glory days, if you want to call them that way. But anyway, this is all about the young fellas today in Milltown Club. We took on a job early on in the year. We weren't that buffet with players, as it turned out, but we went to a few lads, we got them on, we got them in, we stood going. We tried it out. I was hoping myself to play a little bit more football than I did this year. But as it turned out, I wouldn't be able to stick to the pace that the young
Well, with the young lads you're after bringing through, I'm sure, Eddie, you'll be fighting hard for your players.
Well, I don't think there's no way I'll get a pace now after that, there's no doubt. But, as I said, like, the young fella at the end, and our captain, fantastic, Tom Dillon, was unbelievable. He was the older of the team, Seth and Tom Dillon, Damien Gunnan, Willie Keegan might be to an extent. Like they all had serious great games, like, you know, just no doubt. You can't really pick out anybody, but
well, look at Eddie, we leave it at that. It's celebration time now. What can we say when the congratulations on a job well done?
Thanks very much, Ollie.
Eddie Summers there, congratulations. My apologies there, Jerry Summers.
All right, Ollie.
I don't know what I was calling you, but that's what happens when you get too much drinking, Jerry. Well done again.
Thanks very much, Ollie.
Well done.
Thank you.
Well, I think we'll remember the speech when this man got the cup this evening for a long, long day. Tom Dillon, a proud moment for you, Tom, when you picked that cup up today.
One of the proudest ever, yeah. No.
Tom, did you think it was possible today?
Oh, I did. We had no problems at all with our trainer Martin had us all synced up with it. Ever fit into our head that we were well capable of doing it, and it was in our heads going in, so we had no problems, we had no fucking doubt in our minds that we were going to win.
Well, they must have been proud of the boys today.
Oh, sure, it couldn't be any prouder. Great to be captain and synced up to pick up the cup on behalf of the parish and there as well.
We can't but mention the younger lads coming through. It's great to see it happening in a country place like Milltown, Tom.
No, we're all told during the week the young team Mullingar had. We also had a young team. There's three or four of us there. We're around a good way now, but there's a lot of the boys only minors as well. They were in the minor final there again, Mullingar, and a few more boys, 24, 25. I think the future is looking good for Milltown as well.
Well, the hype for this, we weren't talking to before the final, Tom. The build up to this was, we heard in your speech, was something else.
Yeah.
I'm sure when you get back home tonight, it's going to be something unreal.
Oh, great. No, it'd be like fucking Tyrone going back to Tyrone.
To Tyrone.
Yeah, it'd be the same for Milltown. We're out to be green and white everywhere. We all out to congratulate us and everything like that, so.
Well, look at Tom. You deserve and you get. What can we say? And congratulations again on a job well done.
Thanks very much.
Our captain for today, Tom Dillon. Thank you very much, Tom.
Thank you.
Well, now we have a gentleman, and I'm sure he's a proud man going home this evening. Chairman for 13 years, when things were down very low, he kept the thing going alive out there in Milltown, and this evening they're county champions. Mick Dalton.
Yes.
You're a happy man this evening, mate.
Indeed I am, Ollie. Yeah, very happy now.
What have you to say about that? We spoke to you before the game and you were quietly confident it was all going to happen for you.
I'm quite right you were. I'm quietly confident I was, and I said it was delayed for the young lads. I also said it was delayed for the
the senior players, the Damien Gunnans and the Dillons and them boys. And been there since 1989 as chairman. Seen a lot of changes in Milltown, and I've said a lot of changes for an improvement, and I was glad to be part of it. And I'm very proud to be part of it this evening. Especially last year, I stepped down as chairman, Johnny Geraghty took over, and I'm delighted for Johnny as well. His first year there as chairman, it's a great outlet for him, Martin's trainer now.
Well, like yourself, Johnny Geraghty's heart and soul would be in Milltown football for a long number of years as well, Nick.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. All down to the years, the Geraghtys, they were part and parcel of them. Jim Dalton and that. The developments of the pitch, too. It's a great old traditional Gaelic football end of the county, you know, like the heart is in it. We don't win that often, but when we do.
You do it in style.
We do it in style, and it's from the heart. And have you seen the green and white flags around Milltown? And this young team coming up now, it's good for them. And a big, a major development as well coming up in the parish. They opened up a new clubhouse and community hall, and everything goes with people in an area. You know, the Ireland of today, but Milltown somehow is unique, like other patches of Westmead as well. And we're all very proud to be behind our flags. We're also very proud to be behind the maroon and whites as well.
Well, you're on the roll of honours after this evening anyway, Mick.
Yes.
Well, with that, we leave it and we congratulate you, and we look forward to many more years of success in Milltown, and we look forward to the grand opening whenever it is.
Thank you very much, Charlie.
Mick Dalton,
for the moment.
Congratulations and well done both today and all the years you were involved with the club.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Michael.
Good man.
Have a man, and by God, today he stood out heads and shoulders above a lot of fellas here. Damien Gunning. Damien, a proud moment for you.
Yeah, very much now.
What's the feeling tonight?
Of,
I know it's a stupid question to ask you.
Not ask. Unbelievable now. Delighted for the lads, especially Tom Dillon. He's been a brilliant player over the years. Delighted for all the young players as well.
Well, I hope you're putting yourself in that category now.
And delighted for Martin Lane, Ned Summers and Jerry as well. They're putting a lot of work. Brilliant, you know, and hangs all the way. We'll never say it
yet. You have some great men in that club that have kept it going tick and tin with our last number of years, Damien.
Yeah, well, there's a few of us older lads left now, just a few, except for Tom. We're heading over the 30 mark now, won't say what age number.
Well, I'm sure next year in the Intermediate Championship we'll see you talking out again anyway.
Oh, and that's for sure. Anyway, sure. Some part of the field.
You're proud of the lads this evening?
Oh, absolutely. Delighted now. With some session out in the country.
What's your highlight of the day? Or a moment that sticks out that you knew you had the game won?
I suppose Fergus Riley's goal, I have to say, turned it, like, you know, turned the game for us. We needed a score. We're after missing a good few scores. Fergus just got the goal, and after that, we were never going to be dead.
Damien Gunning, what can we say? Congratulations and well done.
Thank you.
Well, we watched them taking the field to play today. We didn't know whether it was himself, his son, or who was going to be taking part in the team. John Dillon, is that right, John?
That's right.
John,
yes.
And of course, you're secretary of the club.
I'm the secretary.
There was a lot of pressure on you today, John.
Not so much now, Ollie. I think the pressure was on the boys, the team.
Well, you were a part of the boys. You were
I am,
the...
yeah. But in a kind of a more an egging on role at this time of my life. I'm getting on a bit now. And.
Well, you were proud of those lads today, John.
Great to see a youthful Milltown team. It's a great sign for the future, and we have a great chance, intermediate, I think, with the help of God.
Well, it wouldn't be fair to be going any man of the match. It was a complete unit today, John.
I couldn't blame anyone. You couldn't look at any man and say he didn't play well. And the substitutions that were brought on at crucial times, and they worked wonders too. Not saying any man that was taken off, he was after working his heart off, and he was best.
What can we say about that man, Martin Lynn? He really had them firing on all cylinders today.
Well, I know Martin Lynn a long time. I went to school with him. I went to secondary school with Martin Lynn. I used to sit beside him. And as far as I'm concerned, Martin Lynn is a pure gentleman. And he's a great motivator. He looked after that team in Milltown this year unbelievably well. We had a bit of a weekend away, which we never had. I'm 20-odd years playing football in Milltown, and we never had such a year as we did with Martin this year. It's a credit to him.
Well, we were just watching them there during, I think, the early part of the second half, when things just weren't going, or maybe in the first half, things weren't just going Milltown's way. And he was quite relaxed up along the side, and there was no shouting or roaring at anyone in particular. He just stepped out and said something to the players here and there, up along the line, off the play. A sign of a good motivator.
He couldn't get better than Martin. Had he stayed, I don't think he panicked at all. He was there, he knew, he's looking at them men. We'd done 109 or 110 sessions in 8.5 months we're training for this junior title. Martin knew the men that he put on the field today, they do the job for him. He didn't get conflustered, he never panicked. And I'll have to say the same for Led Summers and Jerry Summers. No one panicked today because we thought, we knew the panel of players that we had, that the junior title was ours if we worked at our ability, and the training we done during the year would stand to us at the end of the day.
John Dillon, selected secretary and player. What can we say? Congratulations on a job well done.
Thanks very much, Ollie.
John Dillon, it's congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, we just mentioned this man in our previous interview, Martin Lynn, trainer of today's victorious Milltown team. Martin, you're a proud man this evening.
I'm very proud, Ollie, because of the fact that the age of the team, they were absolutely superb. There was about 11 of the team under 22, and the same with Mullingar as well. They had a phenomenally young side, and at the end of the day, the youth that won on the day. Everyone is saying that the first match was far better than the second one, and I think the same as well. And we're well set up to go forward a bit next year as well.
We're just watching it, we just mentioned in the previous interview as well, when things weren't just going well in the first half, you just didn't panic. What was going through your mind at that time, Martin?
Look at Ollie, in the semi-final against St Paul's as well, we were down, but the young lads came so well. We'd introduced that in training as well. We worked so hard in the last 15 minutes of each training session, and it paid off again today. And I had no doubt in the lads, honest to God. I had no doubt in them because they're a super bunch of guys.
Well, it's great to see the, a few experienced lads here and those young lads coming through. That kind of weren't expected to come through nearly a year or two ago.
No, if you said at the beginning of the year that Michael Ward, Patrick Gavigan, who was 17 and 18, and Francis McLaughlin will be on Milltown winning junior side, you'd be laughed around Milltown. But we get them their chance. There's no point in winning a championship with a fella at 40 or 45. So we give the young lads a chance, and it worked out for us on the day.
Well, you're proud of those lads this evening,
I know, Jesus, I'm over the moon for them. I'm over the moon for them. Because we at Lowen boasted that the train 115 times this year. Today was our 110th time for a junior club, and the effort that we did was absolutely phenomenal. At the beginning of the year, 34 of us went to Bundoran on a trip, 30 players and 4 mentors. And the reception we got down there was unbelievable. No mischief, no messing, absolutely super young lads. A credit to them and a credit to the families.
Martin, credit to you and a credit to the lads. What can we say? Congratulations.
Absolutely.
And hopefully celebrations go well for you tonight and long may they last.
Hopefully.
And we look forward to seeing you in intermediate grade in 2004.
Martin Lynn,
trainer of Milltown 2003, congratulations and well done.
Thanks, Ollie.
But, well, we've just taken him away from a lovely big round lump of steak. Paddy Gavigan.
Yes.
Paddy, what's the feeling this evening?
Unbelievable.
What have you to say about those bunch of fellas?
They're brilliant. Brilliant. I never felt this good since 1974, when we won it before. That was when I was there. But
that's not the day of yesterday.
That's not the day. And they're a great bunch of lads there. When we won it in 74, we had 10 fellas, I think, retired after the match. But they're all a young team now, and it's brilliant.
Well, I'm looking at some of those lads, it'll be a few years before a lot of them retire, and I'd say there'll be a few titles won before this event.
Hopefully, as well. It'll be a great, and they're a great credit to the parish. All them lads.
At any stage today, Paddy, were you worried it wasn't going to happen for you?
I was. I was very on edge there in the first half. You can ask my wife in there. My young fellow was playing cornerback and I was giving out about him.
Well, so they're always the first one you'll paint your fingers.
Yeah, I know,
anyway.
They are, yeah, but they came good in the end. They came, the last quarter, they were unbelievable. They were unbelievable. When the Brahim Ollie Rogers and Paul Mahan, you know, an old head and settled the ship, and it was brilliant.
Well, it was a complete change of conditions from what those lads have been training for the last
of
months.
Yeah,
and
that's right, yeah.
They're just complete into the rain, which they haven't been playing for all year, you might say.
They never had a game in the rain.
And it took a bit of time to adjust to it.
And
finally, when they did adjust, it was no answer to them.
There was no answer, and the fellas that came up really trumps in the rain was the like of Damien Gunn and Tom Dillon now, very good Riley, and fellas like that who were experienced players, you know, who knew how to play the rain and the sun.
Well, look at Paddy, you're county champions this evening, you're intermediate now,
right.
And I hope you don't give out to that son tonight.
I won't.
Praise him and keep him going for another long number of years.
Right.
Paddy Gavin, congratulations and well done again.
Thank you, Ollie.
Well, The harder they come, the bigger they fall. And when they did fall, this man was out on the spot to pick them up, Jim Dalton. We all know Jim has a long history of first aid with many a team around Westmead, not alone Milltown, and even our own county of Westmead. A man that holds no grievance against any club in this county is there to help them in any way he can. But by God, today he did his bit for Milltown, Jim Dalton. It's a great for you, Jim.
It is. And thank you. It is, yes. And I'm particularly pleased because I have a long association with Milltown Club. And I have said during the week, it's the first time that we have such a young number of players together representing the club. And where you have young players, it should, hopefully will, represent a bright future. And all those young lads definitely come of age today when they won their first adult competition. We all know you can win as many underage as you like. And while underage is great, it doesn't compare with winning your first adult competition. And I was particularly pleased and particularly delighted for those young lads who progressed during the year off the team and held a place. And I will give credit to the management team who persevered and in giving those young lads a chance. And all in all can take great credit for a job well done.
Well, look at Jim, a job well done is not the words. It is great. As a disappointment of some of those lads on the minor county final this year, it really makes up for that disappointment. It's great to see those lads coming through, and things look healthy in the town for a number of years.
Yeah, hopefully. I know things can change in the modern world today. Society changes, and it's not like, years gone by.
It's celebration time now. What can we say? Congratulations to yourself for what you've done for that club down the years, and we look forward to more success over the next couple of years. Jim Dalton, congratulations. Now, we have the man that calls all the shots out around Milltown, chairman of the club, Johnny Dersey. Johnny, you're a proud man this evening.
Unbelievable. I didn't think when I hear the car today that we would win it, but I'm absolutely thrilled for all the young lads that Martin and Ned and Jerry put out this year, and it's brilliant for to pull it off at the Fosha family. I seen it before. We had to play. We played him in 69, we played in 73, and we eventually won in 74. Martin, Ned and Jerry put out a young team this year with exceptional few, not too young, and they landed this fight.
Well, it's a great feeling that you have young lads like that coming through, Johnny.
It is. We never had as many coming through. Well, it might be wrong to say we never had as many. We have a great crop of young lads coming through now. And hopefully, Milltown's future is secured for the next 8 or 10 years.
Well, were there any stage today, Johnny, were you worried it wasn't going to happen for you?
Well, I was a bit worried when Mullingar got the goal. And I knew that they wouldn't give up, that they'd keep fighting to the end. And as a matter of fact, I was in Wishing Valley more well when